But if you skip the last step, accepting who you are and accepting yourself along the way, that's when it can get bad. Because let me break this down for you. Self-help. How to start and what to know before you start it. Let's go. Self-help, it can be a beautiful thing. But first and foremost, before you start, you have to know what you need to work on. And to be able to do this, you have to identify the things you'd like to change in your life, whether it be physical, financial, emotional, spiritual, whatever it may be. Before you start this journey, make sure you have a clear picture of what it is. First and foremost, write it down. It may be more than one thing. If it is, write it down and keep it with you. After you've written it down, make sure to write out a plan beside it or under it on how you can work on this each and every day. The reason behind this is because, similar to a dam holds back water. And if the dam were to break, the water would flow through. So with the dam, if the dam breaks, the water comes through. Think of it like this. Everything holding you back in your life, in every area of your life that's holding you back, that's the dam. In order to break that dam, you gotta pick at it, hit it over and over and over. And once you get to a point, the water's gonna seep through it, and then it's gonna break the whole dam is gonna break. And that's what you wanna do. If you just hit the dam once, it might chip it a little bit, but you hit it twice, break it a good bit more, but you just keep on hitting at it, it's gonna break. And the water in this analogy would represent your potential. The new you is behind that dam. And once that dam is broken, it's gone. But instead of just working on one dam, it could possibly be multiple dams in your life that you're not aware of. But once you realize these, make this plan to not only break them, but keep them away. Like I said, if you only work on it just one time, just one day, you could chip at it a little bit, but unlike dams, they can be rebuilt back up. After you set your intentions on all you're gonna do, made your list, know what dams you're gonna write off and break up and chip away, I need you to first and foremost accept who you are right now. No matter what it is, whatever you don't like, say, hey, this is me. This is me as I am right now. This is not permanent. This is not who I'm gonna be forever. This is me. At this time in my life, this is me. After you do that, now let's get into this toxic stuff. Have you ever had some candy and it was so good? And it just made you wanna get more and more and more. And you know what happened? You end up actually getting more and more. And every time you ate some more, it felt better and better every time you ate it. You know what that is? Dopamine. That good feeling you get anytime you do something that feels good, right? Apply this to self-help. Once you feel yourself growing and you acknowledge the changes that you are going through, and you see that you're actually changing from the old you to the new you, it's gonna hit you. That shot of dopamine is gonna hit you. You're gonna be like, hey, I'm not the same person I once was. But let me tell you, be careful with this, because is it good to grow? Absolutely. Is it good to grow every day? Absolutely. But if you skip the last step, accepting who you are and accepting yourself along the way, that's when it can get bad. Because let me break this down for you. If you're constantly growing without accepting who you are or where you are, what's gonna happen is you're gonna be on an endless cycle of chasing this high of improvement. And then once you get to that point, it's gonna be like you're never fulfilled or never satisfied with who you are. So if you were to improve, say if you went on a journey for a year, and at the end of that journey, you realize all you've overcome, all you've done, and then you'd be like, hey, I'm proud of who I am. But if you want to keep improving, it's like, okay, I'm proud of who I am, but I'm going to improve on this area of my life. But you see the difference between that versus I don't accept who I am, but I'm just gonna keep on improving so I can feel good. Get all the self-help books, all of that. No, 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 no. And if you're watching this and you're stuck in a trap of that addictive dopamine high of feeling good from improving yourself, take the steps of accepting who you are, accepting what you don't like, what you do like, and once you do that, go from there. Then start to improve on it, and you'll accept it, and you'll feel better about it as well. And also, on this self-help journey your own, you're gonna grow a lot. You might not even recognize yourself anymore. You're gonna grow a lot, a ton. But let me tell you this, in order to grow, you're gonna end up doing things you've never done, because to get to places you've never been, you have to do things you've never done, meaning to get out of your comfort zone. And we're all like lobsters. Might sound weird, might sound crazy, but we're like lobsters. Let me explain, okay? Lobsters, the way their life cycle is, they get a shell, outgrow it, get another one, break out of it. It's a constant cycle until they die. And we're the same way, except we don't have an actual shell. Our shell would be our comfort zone. And once you break that comfort zone and become a new person, you're gonna have to have another comfort zone. You're gonna break that, and it's an endless cycle until you die. Same thing. We as humans were made to grow, and grow. And like Tony Robbins said, in order to be happy, you have to grow. But in order to be happy and grow at the same time, you have to accept where you are. You don't have to settle for where you are. You have to accept where you are and make the decision to improve on where you want to be. All right, let's do a recap. First, to start, identify the problem. 2, make that list. 3, make a plan to tackle that list each and every day. Work on it. Remember the dam. Break the dam. Get that water out. Break it all the way down. Break the dam. Okay? 5. Okay, 5. Remember the toxic part of self-acceptance. Accept yourself before improving. That way, you can be happy along the way and not just at the end of the journey. Because happiness, you can be happy at any moment of your life, because it's like this. If a person kicked you, you'd get mad just like that. The same way you can get mad that quick, you can become happy just as quick. It's all in your head. It's all in your mind. But if you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate it if you gave me a thumbs up, like, drop a comment on if you started your self-help journey yet. And if you like these videos, go ahead and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you can see some more in the future. Thank you for watching, and have a nice day.